Myself and my colleague Pete Higgins want to talk about learning for sustainability, and we're going to do this in a series of three short lectures. But before I describe the content of these lectures, I want to look at learning for sustainability and define it in terms of concepts that you may be more familiar with, concepts such as environmental education and education for sustainable development. So environmental education, well, this can be assumed as holding a more traditional approach, and it mainly is concerned with the ecological agenda. Whereas education for sustainable development takes a more holistic approach, and it takes into account issues related to politics, economy, society, and cultural issues too. And learning for sustainability seems to fit most closely with that approach. So learning for sustainability emphasises two things. First, this notion of continuous engagement across all spheres of education, both formal and non-formal. And second, this idea of capacity building, where we see education as a way of enabling ourselves to feel able to take positive action, both individually and collectively. So returning to the three lectures then, the first lecture looks at learning for sustainability and some of the ideas that underpin this in a bit more detail. The second looks at learning for sustainability in practice, so how would we work with this approach? And the third looks at learning for sustainability in Scotland and how it's embedded across our educational system. So let's look at some key ideas. First, let's consider the role of education and learning.
Back in 2001, Stephen Sterling, Professor of Sustainability Education, wrote that the key to creating a more sustainable and peaceable world is learning.
So Sterling and others believe that a revisioning of education is needed and that this should happen in line with humanistic or ecological values.
In other words, we need to think about our relationships with the human and the non-human world and be aware of, respect and try to understand the biogeochemical properties and systems of the planet that reproduce and support all forms of life.
So we need to find ways to do things differently that really help us get to the heart of the matter of sustainability.
So here is another quote which helps us to see what actually lies at the core of sustainability. And I would also suggest that there are spiritual and cultural dimensions in there too, and it's bound up by values and issues that relate to efficiency, community, locality, spatiality, health, democracy, equity, justice, empathy, diversity, sufficiency, and access to information.
So coming back to key issues, education is important, but so too are relationships. And there's two key words I want to introduce here. The first is intergenerational justice, which is about relationships between one generation and the next. And the second is intragenerational justice, which is about relationships within one generation. And it's important that we hold both of these concepts in our minds when we are working with learners, friends, and others, because we want to always maintain a current view, but also a longer-term view as well. So to summarise, learning for sustainability can be seen as a transformational approach, which encourages all of us, both the learner and the teacher, to feel encouraged and enabled to co-construct solutions to some of the big challenges that we face. And this process is important because quite often these solutions are not always apparent, but the need to address them lies within the individual, and it's also at a collective level as well, both within society and education.